Hello everybody and welcome back on my channel. My name is Alex and today we'll make two more components from the safety valve. And this is the valve and we'll make the split pin also. This will be the split pin. We have here the dimensions. So here are the dimensions for the valve. And here is the split pin. Let's start. We'll start with the valve. Okay, first we'll have to open a new part and here let's make this plane white and now we'll open a sketch in the top plane. Here we'll start with a circle. This circle will have the diameter 56 mm, and now we'll select line and we'll make here two lines just like this. And now select these two lines, make them equal. Okay, and with smart dimension we'll give an angle between these two lines. It will be 120 degrees, and now from this line to this center point here will be 3 mm. Nice. And now let's use circular pattern to multiply this 3 times. So here we'll make 3 instead of 4. And here we'll keep these settings. Tracer OK. Nice. Select this point with this circle and select here make coincide. Do the same with this one, coincide. Now select this and select here make horizontal. And now with trimentis command we'll cut these parts of the circle. We only keep this one. Press it OK, go to features, use extruded boss base command, and here the length will be 60 minus 13 mm, so it will be 47. Press it OK, and now we'll open a sketch on this face and here we'll make a circle. So select circle. This circle will have the diameter 12. Now we'll go to features, use extruded boss base command, reverse here the direction, here will be also 47. Press here OK. Nice. Now we'll open a sketch in the front plane. Here we'll start with a center line. Make it vertical like this. And then we'll select line and we'll make the next sketch. So we'll start from here like this and then up and back to this point. Nice. Now select these two lines, make them parallel, and with smart dimension let's give a dimension for this line. Here will be 6 mm. Okay, and now let's give a dimension from this line to this edge. Here will be 3 mm. Okay, this line here will have 5. From this line to this point, here will be also 5. And from this line to this edge, here should be 60. Okay. And now let's see, we'll have to give an angle for this line, so select that line and this center line, and here the angle will be 45. Okay, and here will be also 45. Nice. And now we'll have to select this line and this center line, and here will be 35 mm. Okay, and now from this line to this point, here will be 36 mm. Nice. And now we'll have to select line again, so and we'll make a line starting from this point until this center line and back to this point. Make these two lines here. and then select this line and select here construction geometry. This will allow us to use revolved boss base. And now go to features, select revolved boss base command, and here we'll have to select this center line. Press here OK. Nice. And now we'll have to make a revolved cut inside here to cut this. And to do this, we'll go to front plane. We'll open a sketch. And now we'll go to display style. We'll select this one, hidden lines visible. And now we'll select center line. We'll make here a vertical center line. And then select line. And we'll start, let's say, from here. Like this, back to this point, and like this. And now let's define this. First, we'll select smart dimension and we'll give an angle from this line to this line, and here will be 45 degrees. And then we'll have to make this line coaliner with this edge. So select this edge, and select this line, and select here make coaliner. Nice, and now everything is fully defined. Go to features, use revolved cut. This center line should be selected here, and press OK. Let's go back to display style and select first one. Nice, and this is the valve. Let's save it. Save it on my desktop. This will be valve. And now let's make the split pin. For that one, we'll have to open another part, and here we'll make this plane white, and now we'll open a sketch in the front plane, and here we'll make a circle. This circle will have the diameter 3 mm, and now we'll go to features, we'll use extruded boss base command, and here the length will be, let's say, 12 mm, and press here OK. And now we'll open a sketch on this face, and here we'll make an extruded cut. First we'll select center rectangle, we'll make a rectangle like this. With smart dimension we'll give here a dimension, let's use here 0.1, and the length for this line will be, we can keep it this one, it just have to be bigger than 3. Press here OK. Now go to features, use extruded cut. Here we'll select through all. Press here OK. And here all bodies and OK. Nice. And now let's open a sketch in the right plane. And here we'll select a 3-point arc. And we'll make an arc starting from this point, just like this. And here let's give a radius for this arc. Here the radius will keep 5. And from this point to this point, here will be 5 mm. Okay, and then from this center point to this one, here will be 6. Okay, let's leave this one. Let's delete it and make it again. So here will be 5.76. Nice, and now we'll have to exit this sketch. And we'll have to use swept boss base command. So select swept boss base. We'll select here at profile, we'll select this face, and then here at path we'll select this arc. Nice. Press OK. And I'll have to do the same thing down here. So we'll open another sketch in the right plane. And here we'll make another 3-point arc starting from this point this time. and this one, let's say it will be something like this. And with smart dimension, let's define it. The radius will use 3 here, and here the dimension will be also 3.76. And let's give here an angle. Let's say 100 degrees. And now exit the sketch. And we'll use sweeped boss base again. Select this face, and here at path we'll select this. And press OK. Nice. And now we'll open another sketch in the right plane. And we'll do almost the same thing here. So we'll start with a 3-point arc again from this point, like this. Nice, now make a center line, make it horizontal, select this arc, this center line, select here mirror, and now we'll select a 3-point arc again, we'll make here an arc, select this point, select here make tangent. And now with smart dimension, we'll give a dimension from this point till this point. And here will be 17. Actually, no, here will be 15. Okay, and now let's give a radius for this. Let's use 3 millimeters, the radius. Okay, or we can use 2.5, I think it's better. And now exit the sketch and go to sweeped boss base again. Select this face, and then here the path will be this sketch. Press here OK. Nice, and now we'll have to fill this gap here, and for this we're gonna use lofted boss base command. So select lofted boss base command, and here we'll have to select this face and then this face. Press here OK. And this will be the split pin. Now we'll have to add some fillets. So select fillet, the radius will gonna keep 1. So here will be 1 millimeter. And we'll select this edge with this edge, and then this edge with this one. Nice, and I think that's it. Press OK, and this is the split pin. This was the tutorial for today. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next tutorial. And if you like it, you can leave a like, you can subscribe if you want to see more tutorials, and you can subscribe if you want to see the next components from this safety valve and the assembly. I think it's gonna be one more tutorial with the components and then the assembly. Thank you, and I hope to see you next time.